Hello, my name is Liz Ness, and I'm the Director of the Office of Education and Compliance in the Center for Cancer Research at the National Cancer Institute. Identifying and monitoring adverse events is critical to protecting research participants and ensuring data integrity. Welcome to a four-part series on adverse events. Part one will focus on AE definitions. Part two will focus on AE assessment and documentation. Part three will focus on reporting of adverse events for investigational new drug and investigational device exemption studies. And the final module, part four, focuses on reportable events to the IRB, which includes more than just adverse event reporting. Understanding the various definitions associated with adverse events is the first step to understanding adverse events. At the end of part one, I hope that you will be able to define the following: an adverse event, a serious adverse event, a life-threatening event, an unexpected adverse event, a suspected adverse reaction, and finally, an unexpected adverse device effect. Let's first take a look at a summary definition of an adverse event. An adverse event is any unwanted sign, symptom, or disease that was not seen before an individual's research participation or a worsening of a baseline symptom, regardless of expectedness or relationship to research. It is important to note that multiple clinical terms have been used to convey an adverse event, including toxicity, side effect, acute or late effect, complication, adverse drug reaction. However, all of the terms you see on this slide imply that an intervention caused the adverse event, which, as the previous slide showed, is not what the definition of an adverse event is in clinical research. The purposes of adverse event monitoring or surveillance, especially for those events related to the study intervention or procedures, include identifying events that may have immediate effect on the safety of our research participants. They help to inform our regulators, investigators, and others of new and important information about adverse events. And finally, they provide a summary of adverse experiences in order to develop a drug or regimen toxicity profile. The first slide with the AE definition is sort of what I refer to as my summary slide. So now let's take a look at the evidence that helps to support that definition. So there are various definitions from different regulators. The first, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services regulations at 45 CFR Part 46 actually does not define or use the term adverse event. However, the Office for Human Research Protection, or OHARP, which provides leadership in the protection of our research participants and the welfare of them, they do define adverse event in a guidance document. In their guidance on reviewing and reporting unanticipated problems involving risks to subjects or others and adverse events, the term adverse event is used very broadly and includes an event meeting the following definition: any untoward or unfavorable medical occurrence in a human subject, including any abnormal sign, for example, an abnormal physical exam or laboratory finding, symptom or disease temporally associated with the subject's participation in the research, whether or not considered related to the subject's participation in the research. This definition has been modified from the definition of adverse events from the 1996 International Council on Harmonization, or ICH, E6 guidelines for good clinical practice, which we'll look at shortly. Under the FDA investigational new drug application regulations found at 21 CFR Part 312, the FDA defines an adverse event as any untoward medical occurrence associated with the use of a drug in humans, whether or not considered drug-related. And finally, the International Council for Harmonization of Technical Requirements for Pharmaceuticals for Human Use good clinical practice guidelines, or simply ICHGCP, defines an adverse event as any untoward medical occurrence in a research participant administered a pharmaceutical product and which does not necessarily have a causal relationship with the treatment. You can see how this is similar then to OHARP's guidance definition. However, please note that at the time of this taping, there is a draft version of GCP guidelines, which provides a slightly varied definition of adverse event. The draft guidelines, which came out in May of 2023, defines an adverse event as any unfavorable medical occurrence in a trial participant. The adverse event does not necessarily have a causal relationship with the treatment. So it is slightly different, intent the same. So let's take a look at a few more definitions associated with adverse events. We're going to take a look at serious, life-threatening, unexpected, SAR, and UADE. So a little bit of alphabet soup there. So a serious adverse event is based on the outcome of the adverse event. It doesn't have anything to do with how severe the adverse event was. And this is used to help determine reportability to our regulators, whether that's to the IRB or to the FDA. So a serious adverse event is an adverse event that results in any of the following: a death, life-threatening adverse drug experience, an inpatient hospitalization or prolongation of an existing hospitalization, persistent or significant incapacity or substantial disruption of the ability to conduct normal life functions, a congenital anomaly, birth defect, or an important medical event or IME that may not result in death, be life-threatening, or require a hospitalization, but may be considered serious when, based on appropriate medical judgment, it may jeopardize the patient or the subject and may require medical or surgical intervention to prevent one of the outcomes listed in this definition. An example of that is an allergic bronchospasm requiring intensive treatment either in an emergency room or at home. So let's take a moment to look at the definitions that are associated then with the SAE definition. One of those is life-threatening. A life-threatening event is an adverse event or a suspected adverse reaction if, in the view of either the investigator or the sponsor, its occurrence places the patient or subject at immediate risk of death. It does not include an adverse event or a suspected adverse reaction that, had it might been more severe, it might have caused death. And again, that's an example, the example of the allergic bronchospasm fits this category as well. So regulations and guidances don't really define what an expected event is, but rather when an event is deemed unexpected. So when looking at the FDA definition under the IND application, when assessing an adverse event to determine if you need to report this in what we refer to as an expedited manner, which we'll talk more about in part three, an adverse event then would be considered unexpected if it wasn't listed in the investigator brochure or at the specificity or severity that has been observed, or if the investigator brochure is not required or not available, that it's not consistent with the general risk information described in the investigational plan, otherwise known as a protocol, or elsewhere in the IND application. If it's mentioned in the IB as occurring with the drug class or anticipated, or it's anticipated based on pharmacological properties of the drug, but it may not be specifically mentioned in the investigator brochure. So here are the definitions of for OHARP and ICH-GCP for an unexpected adverse event. So OHARP guidance defines an AE that's not described in terms of the nature, severity, or frequency, or in GCP definition, it's an adverse reaction, the nature, severity of which is not consistent with what is known already about the product, such as what's found in the investigator brochure or a package insert. So a couple of other FDA definitions to look at. I had mentioned previously a suspected adverse reaction, and a SAR, S-A-R, is basically an adverse event related to the drug being studied on a clinical trial. FDA's definition is any AE for which there is a reasonable possibility that the drug caused the adverse event. And reasonable possibility means there is evidence to suggest a causal relationship between the drug and the adverse event. And that bolded and underlined evidence is really key. This can include a single occurrence of an adverse event that's uncommon and known to be strongly associated with drug exposure, or one or more occurrences of an adverse event that is not commonly associated with drug exposure, but is otherwise uncommon in the population that has been exposed to the drug. Or finally, an aggregate analysis of specific events observed in a clinical trial that indicates those events occur more frequently in the drug treatment group than in a concurrent group or a historical control group. And then finally, in device research, the FDA regulations don't specifically define serious or life-threatening, but understanding these definitions, as we have already looked at them, will help you to understand and to know when you have an unanticipated adverse device effect, or UADE. This is any serious adverse effect on the health or safety of any life-threatening problem or death caused by or associated with a device, if that effect, problem, or death was not previously identified in nature, severity, or degree of incidences in the investigational plan or application, or any other unanticipated serious problem associated with the device that relates to the right, safety, or welfare of the subjects. So slightly different, but you see common threads of nature and severity. So in closing, adverse event surveillance helps to ensure the safety of our research participants. It's critical to understand that the definition of an AE is regardless of the expectedness or relationship to the research, and that there are other definitions that we have reviewed that will assist you in determining if and how an adverse event will be reported to sponsors or other regulatory bodies. So let's test your knowledge. What is the definition of an adverse event? Is it A, a known toxicity of the study agent? B, any untoward sign or symptom that occurs during the course of a clinical trial? C, any adverse event which the PI decides to report during the course of a clinical trial, or a side effect caused by the study agent? And the correct answer is actually B. Remember, toxicity, side effect imply an attribution or a relationship, which is not part of the definition of an adverse event. And the PI needs to follow what the definition of an AE is, not just make that decision on themselves. And one more, test your knowledge. What type of adverse event is the following scenario? A research participant slips on an icy sidewalk and suffers a leg fracture requiring an inpatient surgery. The investigator says this is not related to the investigational product. So A, it's not an adverse event at all. B, it's an AE only. C, it's an adverse reaction. D, it's a serious adverse event. And the correct answer is D. It is an SAE or a serious adverse event. Thank you for listening to part one of adverse events.